Hey everybody, real quick, I just want to tell you, don't do it. Don't do it. What is it am I telling you not to do? What is it that I don't want you to not do? I'll tell you in this video. Welcome to the Champions for Christ Christian Church Bookwork. I'm your host, Dr. Darryl L. Jones, and I'm the Senior Pastor of Champions for Christ Christian Church, where I thank God for allowing me the opportunity to serve some of the best people you would ever want to meet in your life. So what is it I don't want you to stop doing? I don't want you to stop coming to church. I don't want you to stop going to church. I don't want you to think that church is something that we could take lightly. And I know a lot of us got used to being online with our church services through the pandemic when we had the COVID that was going through our nation. And a lot of times, out of safety, most people stayed home, which I understand. But now, we're going everywhere. Don't stop going to church. You haven't stopped going to Walmart. You haven't stopped going to Publix, Kroger, other stores that you may shop. You haven't stopped going out to see the games. You haven't stopped going out to brunch and all these other things. So why are you stopped coming to church? You know, if you are honest, we really don't have an excuse now not to go to church, even if you do go online. But I want us to get back into the idea of coming back together. As a matter of fact, there's a Bible verse that talks about how we're supposed to come together. And it says this: do not forsake assembling, which basically means we are to assemble. But furthermore, it is a wise word that is written to protect us from a lot of different things, like attacks from the enemy, our hearts becoming hard as a rock, and those D's, discouragement, doubt, and depression. Because when we assemble as the body of Christ, we are to stir each other up in love and encourage one another in our faith. You know, I could say a lot of churches, I understand, we are struggling with assembling, bringing people back together. And if you are like me, our church, we're still online virtually because currently we don't have a building to worship in. And we are looking for a building to worship in. And I'm pretty sure at the right time, God will have the right building for us. So if you are aware of a building that you know they might be available for a church to use on Sunday mornings, and please reach out to anyone at Champions for Christ Church or myself and just let us know, because I do understand the importance of us assembling together. And yes, like some of y'all, I've gotten comfortable online. I love coming to you on this platform, and I won't stop coming to you on this platform. But I do believe in the importance of us as Christians assembling together in a designated space for worship. In that text that I read to you from Hebrews 10, chapter 25th verse, it basically tells us that Paul was clear. We are to do this even more so as Jesus draw near to return to us. What am I talking about doing this? I'm talking about assembling, coming together as a church in person. So how do we start this assembling? It's easy. Reach out to a family member. Reach out to a friend and let them know, hey, let's gather together in fellowship. Let's gather together in prayer. Let's come together as a body and strengthen one another in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Another thing, reach out to your family and friends. Say, hey, let's study God's word together. You know, or whatever that you're going through, be it finances, relationship, romances, children, jobs, or whatever it is, ask a family friend, hey, let's see what the word of God has to say about whatever the particular situation is. That's what happens when we come together. We come together to encourage, inspire, motivate, love on, care for, and be available to one another. That's what Jesus showed us as he assembled his discipleship team, as he assembled all his followers. Jesus was present. He was in the midst of them as they got the word from God, from Jesus, as they worshiped how good God was, as they thanked God for all that God had done. So don't do it. Don't stop going to church. Don't quit going to church. And don't get so caught up into all the distractions of Sunday brunch, getting your day of rest, which is God's day of rest, or going out playing golf, running, biking, in your yard working, cleaning your cars, cleaning your house. You have all the rest of the week for that. Can you spare at least a couple hours on a Sunday morning to assemble together in worship? Thank you so much for tuning in to the Champions for Christ Christian Church Bookwork, where I'm your host, Dr. Darryl L. Jones, and I'm the senior pastor of this wonderful church that God has allowed me to lead and serve as a servant leader. Don't forget, I have a book available, and this book is an amazing book, and it's called Winning on Purpose. Get this book right now. You can go to Amazon.com. If you're in the Atlanta area, you can call me or text me or email me, and I can meet you somewhere and get this book and put it in your hand. So go on and put it in your cart right now. Reach out to me, and I'll put it in your hand. That's right, Winning on Purpose. This book here, you might have a college student, some high school students that's getting ready to go back to school. Let this be one of the major books they read this year. A college student shouldn't go to college without this book in their hand. So go to Amazon.com right now, or you can reach out to me, c4cchurch@gmail.com, or you can reach out to me online on Facebook or either one of my social media pages. Well, thank you so much for tuning in to the Champions for Christ Christian Church Bookwork. And until we're together again, we are Champions for Christ. Peace.